The only things I've seen at South by Southwest this year has been hip hop shows. I like this guy Little B from the Bay Area, and I like Freeway. I saw him play his new stuff. And I went to the, today, earlier this day afternoon, I went to a party called the Beat Society, which is kind of like a neo-soul Philly rap thing that I really, that's my friends put on from back in the old days in Philly. What do I think about the jerk movement? I'm really into it. I like that it's young kids doing it. I like that it's like a high school phenomenon. I like that the buzz has started from the kids who like the kids. It's not fabricated, you know, like a lot of music. And I like that, I like the producers a lot. I like Jay Hawk, who's done a lot of stuff for Pink Dollars and the New Boys. And I like that his sound, I like the way he does his thing. It's very cool. I don't know if I created it, but I definitely, like, there's something happening. There's definitely, like, kids everywhere are, like, the best example is a party on Thursday night called the Tormenta Tropical Party. And it was, like, these guys from the Bay Area who are friends of mine from Argentina. The party was sick. They had this guy Kingdom, Elvis, Toy Selecta, and Guzu Guzu, these kind of like outsiders that do a tropical cumbia Latin house kind of flavor, and the party was sick. They had every kind of genre across the board playing. But the whole vibe was this kind of tropical world vibe, you know? I think that anytime you play music for people, my bass has been like, my only inspiration for doing a DJ set has always been to rock a party, so you want everybody to go crazy. You want to play music that people go crazy. You can easily do that by playing a Kesha record or whatever, a pop records and stuff like people that know, they're gonna go crazy, but to play new records is a bit tricky. So the goal is to have a rhythm where you can sneak people a record that they don't know, you know? That's like what a DJ does well. So for me, I always gotta have, if I play a really crazy record from another country or a different style or a world record, I gotta put it in a context somehow so people can get it. I mean, Major Lazer for me has always been that kind of like a project to contextualize dancehall and reggae music to people. And we think we've been successful with that, you know? You hear Pon the Floor, you don't think it's a dancehall record, but that's the biggest record in Jamaica right now. It's become huge there. It's a dancehall record for them, but for us, it's just like a weird, crazy club record. But it's part of our Major Lazer project, you know? And a record is a dancehall album. So it's always a trick to kind of contextualize things so people can get them. So I think we managed that with that project. As a DJ, you always hear me play different things. I'm not really concerned about anybody. I'm not concerned about anything. I'm just concerned to like do the best job I can. You know, I play different records, play this, that, for other people, this people. I've gone from like corporate parties with suits to like, you know, parties in the favelas that the promoters, you know, are just friends that I meet on Twitter. You know, I go deep into the hood. Or I play like a jerk party in LA and I might play like a hipster party that night. Or I might play like someone's, you know, high school prom, and then I'll play like a 1,000 capacity nightclub in a couple hours. You're not gonna find me in the same party twice, you know? I'm always doing different stuff. Yeah, you heard that? That's about from 2005, 2006. It's a really old, that's when I played all vinyl. And I got invited to China for the first time, and I brought a super giant, heavy crate of records. Had to pay extra luggage costs. All vinyl, scratching acapellas, scratching instrumentals, playing new records. Yeah, that's cool you heard that. That's an old mix, yeah. It came out like about 2 months ago, but I just found the CD. I went to China again in October with Steve Aoki, and the guys who put that party on saw me and they said, hey, we recorded your set from 2005. And I was like, really? Give it to me. And I listened to it, I was like, damn, this is pretty good. It's all old style. Yeah, it's a bit, it's like kind of old. A throwback.
5 years ago, yeah.
Yeah, no, it was definitely from 5 years ago. At the time, the A. Marie record was big. Galang was big by MIA. I don't know what else is on that, to be honest, but it's definitely like kind of that. It's the era of 2005, 2006. It's not. I mean, like, you know, I just like to make records that don't sound like anything else, you know? And I think, like, some of the stuff we have on our label, like, there's a guy, like, for a good instance, this guy named Elvis 1990. We put out a record by him called United Groove. And the record is, it's kind of deep, it's kind of broken. And we put it out 6 months ago, and it took 6 months for, like, DJs to really latch onto it as, like, an anthem. Because it was so different, it sounded so different. Pon the Floor, even, when you first hear that, you're like, what the hell is going on? It's just drum rolls, and then a big voice sample pitched up and down. And I think that it works. It's just, you have to have something that really signifies an identity for yourself, you know? It has to be different than everything else, because music all blends together. I mean, if I play like a couple dubstep records in the middle of a house set, people really remember that, because it sounds different than the house music. Or if I play like a hip-hop record randomly, they're gonna remember that, you know? No, the primary role of a DJ for any time is to rock a party. Like, flatly, that's what you gotta do. I'm inspired by doing that. You know, I'm inspired by playing new records. I took a cue from someone like Afrika Bambaataa that was playing these parties in the Bronx, these disco parties, and breaking like rock records and Kraftwerk. And back then they were funky records. They got into the party and they changed the way people think about music. But they were definitely different. It was definitely taking a chance. I'm doing the same thing with records now, trying to take a chance and play records that people don't know about. That's kind of the inspiration for me. And I think a lot of DJs, like, you'll hear hip-hop DJs, traditional hip-hop DJs, and they'll be playing house records now. Power 106 in LA is almost like 80% house music, and it's a hip-hop station. So, I mean, you just have to stay ahead. If people want house music, you gotta play house music. The tide just always changes, you know? I mean, you still have like that kind of like underground style of hip-hop, but I'd say someone like DJ Drama, because I played parties with him, he plays a little smidgen of house music, but he definitely has, like, he has a whole fan base around him doing the Gangsta Grillz mixtapes and putting on all these different Atlanta artists. People that build a whole foundation and a whole scene around them, like his name, like what Drama does. I don't know. Funkmaster Flex is still a kind of icon. I mean, you always gauge the crowd and you want to give them what you got to kind of guess what they want and steer them this direction, that direction. It's like going on a boat cruise. You got to, like, you're the captain, you know? And you go this way, you don't want to capsize. It might be a stormy, you don't want to tip over. You gotta kind of get people over to this island or this island. You gotta kind of steer them away, you know? You gotta like gauge the crowd and figure out what they want. You can't really go in there with the guns blazing and play whatever you want. I kind of do that with Major Lazer. I just do that because people want to hear the Major Lazer. When I do Diplo, I play a bit of everything. I have about 50 songs, and from those pool of songs, maybe like, you know, like maybe 10 of them are album, and the other 40 might be different random little samples and stuff. So I always kind of like change the side. You know, I might pick a song there, but it definitely changes. But it's going to be the same 40, 50 songs.